Okay, we're gonna use a radio group and we are going to vote for our favorite band in the radio group, and then we're gonna keep count and we're gonna check who's the winner at the end of the whole process. The radio group works with items. So I'm gonna add items here. Let's just add three bands. Okay, that's the bands that we are allowed to vote for. This will be our vote button, and this one will be the button that will determine the winner. Three labels to display the amount of votes for every band. So they all are going to start with zero. I'm going to make three global variables. I band one. Band two. Band three. Integer. And when this form is created, I'm going to set all three variables to zero so that they all start with the value zero. Everybody's going to start with zero, so it's going to be fair. Then the user can select his favorite band in the radio group and then click on vote. And I'm going to check which one was selected. Radio group one. Item index. If the item index is zero, that means that the first band was selected. Okay, so that means band one. I'm going to increase the value of band one by one. Okay, so if the second radio group is selected, the second one selected, that means item index one. Of course, the radio group starts with item index zero. 1 and 2. If nothing is selected, item index will be -1. So the second one is selected, that means item index 1. You must increase I band 2 by 1. If the item index is 2, that means the third band was selected. We need to increase the value of the third variable by 1. I also want to display the values in the labels as the values change. So label 1 caption equals to band 1. This is integer. Everything that's displayed is displayed as a string, so I need to convert this integer to a string. Int to str. I'm going to do this for the other two bands as well. This one I want to display in label 2. and it should display the value band 2 negative. For band 3, the label will be label 3. This label 3, and it should be the variable I band 3. Counting for Placebo, Gaslight Anthem, and Alkaline Trio. Now we need to code the winner button. So the winner, I'm going to say if band 1 is bigger than band 2 and band 1 is bigger than band 3, and I need to put it in round brackets, so it's going to calculate the value here, true or false, and with an AND statement, if both values is true, that means this value will be true and this value will be true, then it's going to do the coding between the beginning and the end. Okay, so here, let's use a message dialog to display the window. Okay, so band 1 is placebo, that means it's bigger than band 2, placebo is bigger than band 3. Okay, so now, the second one that we want to test. So if band 2, Gaslight Anthem, if it's bigger than band 1, and band 2 is bigger than band 3, then the winner should be Gaslight Anthem. Code Alkaline Trio. So if band 3 is bigger than band 1 and band 3 is bigger than band 2, then the winner will be Alkaline Trio. Placebo is the winner. Gaslight Anthem is the winner. Increase this one. Alkaline Trio is the winner. Okay, so let's code it now for in case there's a draw. So if there's a draw, let's just display a message saying there's no clear winner. Or a draw has been. There's a draw or something like that. So if I band 1, say it's bigger than I band 2, and I band 1 is equals to I band 3. That means that first band was bigger than the second one, but the first one is not bigger than the third one. So that means that there's no clear winner. There was a draw between band 1 and band 3. Then we said, let's say, show message. No winner. Let's test it for another condition. If band 2 is bigger than band 1, band 2 is equals to band 3. That means that band 2 and 3 has the same amount of votes. There will also be no clear winner. The last one. If band 3 is bigger than band 1, and band 3 is equals to band 2, there is no clear winner. Let's say the votes. Let's test it quickly. No message. Okay, so band 1 and band 2 were drawn. So there's no option for that one. Band 1 and band 2. Let's add an option for that one. So band 1 was bigger than band 3, but band 1 is equals to band 2. No winner. Okay, so now we need to code in case all three of them is the same. If band 1 is equals to band 2 and band 1 is also equals to band 3, there will be no winner. No winner. No winner. Let's check. Band 1, band 2, band 3. So this is for band 1. This is for band 2. This is band 3. Let's just test this one. So there's two goes there. No winner. I think I have all the options here. Just check if there's somebody that has the same votes. And that person is actually, that band is actually the winner. Then we can say there's no clear winner. But with this one, that means that band 1 was the clear winner because it's bigger than band 2 and band 3. In this case, band 2 was bigger than band 1 and 3, and in this case, band 3 was bigger than band 1 and band 2.